The National Labor Relations Board announcing Monday nurses at the Mayo Clinic Health System in Mankato voted 213 to 181 to remove the Minnesota Nurses Association from the hospital. It comes more than 70 years after the nurses first unionized there, backed now by the National Right to Work Foundation.
It's always good to assist workers, I mean, but it was their choice ultimately, and I think they spoke pretty loudly with this vote.
Employees can file a decertification petition with the NLRB after collecting signatures from at least 30% of workers, a move the foundation says this group started last month, calling it a common one.
How common is it, though, to decertify in the midst of a contract?
Well, it's not commonplace. That's just a reality.
Labor employment law professor David Larson says union popularity is in fact going up, winning 70% of elections in the last 5 years, while NLRB data shows the number of decertification petitions filed in the last decade is going down from 472 to 240.
If you want to have any kind of voice, you're going to need to have a union if you're nurses because you're not at the top of that pecking order.
Larson says unions increase health and safety, benefits and wages, and decrease absences. And yet, while it's unclear what led to this latest decision, Semin says high dues, unresponsive union officials, and political stances are frequent reasons.
They're not put under a one-size-fits-all union contract, which often hurts individual workers.
The union now has a week to file any objections, which could play out in court. Otherwise, the nurses can file for new representation in about a year. Jennifer Hoff, CARE 11 News.